These are their children. This is Chris, the firstborn son. This is little Stewie. Oh boy, he's a handful. Meg. Big booty bitch gonna shake it, sit on my dick trying to break
it. I throw some cash in that bitch gonna rake it. He flex some cash on the net, I'ma take. And a toddler is the worst kind of know-it-all because they know absolutely nothing but argue everything. Just constant arguments over just nonsense. I'd be reading him a bedtime story, you know, and then the jaguar walked through the forest. That's a tire! One of us can read, as I was saying. The jaguar walked through the... That's a tiger! All right, let's play a little game. Raise your hand if you have a degree. Ah, this is awkward for you. Raise your hand if you can eat pancakes and not have syrup on your face 8 hours later. Jaguar.
So, I didn't come out as a lesbian till I was 35 years old. And what I really wish I had back then was just some sort of a lesbian starter kit. Like, you open the box and boom, there it is. Pride flag. Flannel. Boom. Nail clipper. Just something, anything.
This is the product of childhood trauma. Cute, ain't he?
You might just be the horniest person I've ever seen.
What's your favorite color, Nick?
Blue? No, green.
Awesome. I love learning about you.
I fucked up. It's yellow.
Hi. If you're seeing this, there's like a 90% chance that you're...
Blows up pancakes with mine.
My fucking pancakes.
Tommy. Good girl. Yes, you are. Yes, you are such a good girl. Hi.
She's not a pet.
I gotta take care of something real quick. Hi, Slushy. You're such a good girl. Yes, you are. I can teach you later.
Quick. Let's go.
Oh, no! Oh, the misery.
My fursuit has a hidden secret. Since he is themed around a night sky, I had a special Easter egg added to his paws. If you look closely, the material used is also a night sky filled with stars.
Free hugs. Wait. Sorry, bud. Maybe next time. Bye-bye.
Always think the best, you always thought I'd have a life I could grow with you. But as time fades, crazy how our lives change, feeling like a shockwave without you. Always think about you, always thought I'd have a life I could grow with you. But as time fades, crazy how our lives change, feeling like a shockwave without you. Always think about you, always thought I had a life.
Check this out.
Yeah? George, that's the devil. You're summoning the devil. Stop it.
As a female streamer that watches you every day,
yeah?
I just wanted to say thank you for being an inspiration to all of us.
Oh.
My friends and I, ha ha ha, just kidding. We all know it's a sausage fest in here.
Shut up, Georgie!
Papa, are what? Hot dogs considered tacos?
I'm gonna let the ocean take me, chat. I'm gonna let the ocean take me.
I need to know, could you be the one to call when I lose control?
Wanna see a magic trick? Good. Abracadabra!
These are the top 5 misconceptions I hear about furry conventions. Number 1, you need a fursuit to attend. No, you don't. Everyone is welcome, costume or no costume. Like, it doesn't even have to be a fursuit. Look at how many people are in a fursuit in this panel that I ran. Not many, right? Costumes are cool, but they're not required. Number 2, it's all just a weird sex thing. You know what? For some people it is, but for the vast majority it isn't. You should let adults have adult fun, but also respect the people who don't. There are so many other amazing parts to this fandom. Some people just like dressing up and goofing off in big animal costumes. Number 3, you need to be a furry to attend a furry convention. No, you don't. You can just go. You don't need to identify as a furry. It's a convention. Conventions are fun. Cosplayers are welcome. And number 4, no, I heard it was a sex thing for real. I saw that episode of CSI. Okay, so after 9 p.m, the costumes do get more adult. Parents, take your kids home before that time, please. And yes, just like how some cosplayers have sex in their costumes, the majority don't. Because that shit is expensive, and it's hard to wash. Again, there are so many other things going on at furry conventions, it's kind of silly to dwell on the topic. Live dance battles, musical performances, a lot. But yes, it is part of the fandom. No, it doesn't have to be part of your experience. It's not part of mine. Number 5.
Testing.